Hello guys, first of all I would like to apologize for the sound of my voice because I'm currently sick, as you can hear, so yeah, sorry about that. And let's just start with the video. So the Burning Legion started with a corrupted titan called Sargeras. He saw the power of the Void Lords and how powerful would be titans that would be corrupted by Void Lord, so in his madness and despair, he came to the conclusion to destroy every planet so the Void Lords couldn't corrupt any planet that had Titan in it. And when madness overtook him, he released demons that he imprisoned and killed Pantheon. Pantheon is a group of all the Titans. Then he came to the world Argus, where he saw potential in the native race called Eredar. And this is where we start in our hierarchy of the Burning Legion. So as you could assume, Sargeras is the creator and leader of the Burning Legion, and then we have Kil'jaeden, his right hand, and Archimonde, his left hand. It is said that Kil'jaeden was ranked above Archimonde, but I believe Kil'jaeden's mission is to enlist more races to the Burning Legion, like he did with Kale and tried to do with Illidan, and many alike. While Archimonde is the Legion field commander and directs every Legion invasion of planets. So basically Kil'jaeden is the guy that is behind everything and just gets more people into the Burning Legion so to bolster their forces, and the Archimonde is the one that goes around killing everyone. That's pretty much it. And now we can separate this into two different wings. So the Kil'jaeden's wing starts with Thalrath. Thalrath was Velen's friend, but he betrayed Velen, and then when Velen escaped, he was the one who was hunted and searching for Velen and escaped Eredar's eyes. Then, after Thalrath, we have Dumnor Khazad, who was given his weapon by Archimonde himself. In the third war, he was trapped on Azeroth, and his plot was to reopen Dark Portal, in which he eventually succeeded. Then, beneath him, we have Nathrezims. Nathrezims are current intelligent Jedlords who orchestrated strange actions in Azeroth, led by Tychonius, and after his death, Anatheron took lead. Then after Anatheron's death, it is believed that Mephistrat is the leader of Nathrezim, since he was third in command, although he haven't seen in games so far. On the Archimonde side of the hierarchy, beneath him we have Pitlords that are equally hierarched as Nathrezim's, led by a Manard, and after his death, Azrael is their new leader. Beneath them all, we have several Leotans, namely Lord Jaraxxus, High Lord Gruul, Gul'dan, Sevius, etc. At the end, there are numerous Legion races, lesser demons containing Imps, Voidwalkers, etc., Fellstalkers, Shivaras, Floating Eye, Demonic Hounds, Jailers, Arnassi, Felbats, Sayyad or Succubuses, Mo'arq, Manari, Eredars, etc. So, I know this video is kinda short, but this is basically it about the hierarchy. I have listed all of the characters in the hierarchy in the Burning Legion. I did that because I saw a lot of people didn't really know where they would place certain characters like Gul'dan. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Rate it, thumbs up or thumbs down, and until next time guys.